Well, it seemed like business as usual. They all went out. They seemed comfortable, very confident. They went through all the required elements. Skating actually very, very well. I think for a top six finish, I think that's about the best the U.S. can do, and I think that could come from Mino and San with a solid performance.
The current world champions are Canadians, Isabelle Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler. How do you assess their chances?
Well, they've been struggling all week with a rib injury that Isabelle has. It's been affecting their jumps and a lot of their more difficult tricks, but it seems like they're getting stronger every day. Today was the best practice I think I've seen them have.
The real spotlight all this week has been on the competitive battle between the last two pairs gold medalists. Kordieva and Grinkov won this title in 1988.
Well, when they arrived here, everybody thought they're so much better than they've ever been. They've matured, they've grown, and today's practice, the only double axle she missed was in the run-through of their tech program, but she didn't miss another one the rest of the session. I think they're looking as solid as anybody imagined they could be.
Unfortunately, that is not the case for the pair that won the gold medal in 92. Natasha Mishkutenok and Artur Dmitriev, real problems today.
They seem to be unorganized. They're a little distracted. They've been inconsistent in practice, and today they had a disastrous practice in their technical program. First, she fell in the double axel. They got up, and in what is normally a routine maneuver, a lift, he dropped her. She came right down from above his head, and it looked like a serious injury, but I think that they're going to be okay.
After the practice was over, Tracy Wilson talked with their coach, Tamara Moskvina.
Tamara, Natalia and Artur had a nasty fall in the practice. How are they?
They're okay now, but this was really a disaster. The practice was very bad.
What was the problem? Was it men?
It seems to me that she just realized that it's Olympic Games, and she started to be nervous from the very beginning. In such cases, I say, don't start competing now.
What can you do to help them get prepared for the competition tonight? We've only got a couple of hours.
I will talk to them. I will hypnotize them with my eyes. What can I do? I just will wait and hope that they will get themselves together.
So G&G on the ice tonight. That's Gordieva and Grinkov. G&G could stand for gold and gold. Gold in 88,
sure
gold
could.
In 94. And if I remember correctly, back in 92, you kind of enjoyed Artur Dmitriev, didn't you?
I did. But, you know, getting back to Gordieva, she was just 16 in 1988, and she was very, very tiny, like 86 pounds. And the program was really geared toward her because she was a pixie, and everyone loved to see her, and she was showcased. Now it's a more equal pairing, and as Scotty mentioned, they're a more mature group, and some folks think that they're better than ever.
Yeah, she's gone from a little girl to a mother now. She had a baby back in 1991. Baby was born in New Jersey. That's really just a blockbuster duel tonight. And let's not forget about the Canadians either that will be performing. That's Eisler and Brasseur, who are the reigning world champions. We're right now going to...
After you-